If I asked you right now what you thought innovation was, what would you tell me? Would you tell me something like maybe Steve Jobs and the iPhone, which I'm pretty sure most of you have in your pockets right now? Or maybe you would tell me something about Bill Gates and his Microsoft company, which has basically taken over the world at this point. Or maybe you would tell me about Elon Musk and all the crazy things he said about space and his Tesla company. Well, if you do, then this is probably what you think that innovation is. There's two main factors that go into it, an object and money. Let's go back to Steve Jobs. His object that he wanted to innovate was the phone. And to do that, he needed the money. Yes, he had the people, but in the end, that money is what created the iPhones that we have now. I mean, look at this. There's like 10 iPhones out now. That's a lot. But this actually isn't the only way that innovation can happen. In fact, you really don't even need money. Let me show you. So this girl right here, her name is Alif Biglin. Alif is in Istanbul, Turkey, and she noticed how much plastic pollution there actually was in Turkey. And she really wanted to solve that because no one else was actually doing anything about it. People were just standing by and letting it happen. So she took it into her own hands. She decided, now is when I start researching, and she did. And this is what she came up with. Now look, we've already replaced the money. Now we have a situation. Her situation was the plastic pollution. She wanted to resolve that. And she actually innovated on the object, which was plastic. And what did she end up doing? Well, she ended up with banana peels. Now, I'm not saying that she made banana peels. What she did do is she took those banana peels and made them into bioplastics. And doing all of that led to her ultimate innovation. And in fact, she even won the Google Science Fair a few years ago. But again, this isn't the only way that innovation can happen, because now you don't even need an object. Now, to actually show you this example, I'm going to give you more of a personal story. So this right here is my beautiful family. We have my mom, my cousins, everybody. But there's one person here who isn't actually related to me. In the far right, there's this dude. His name's Chirag. Chirag is my basically childhood best friend, because I was born in India and I moved here when I was pretty young, and I haven't seen him in a while. So a few years ago, going into the summer of eighth grade, I was told by my dad that we were going to India for the marriage and stuff, but I didn't really care about that. I just really wanted to see my friend. So when we got there, we did the basic kid things. We would play badminton, we would play soccer, we would go to the park, we would just walk together and talk about life. But there was something weird that I noticed, because every time that we went out, he would take me to this weird place, and I was very creeped out because it was just a hole in the wall that was supposed to be a store, but there were just scraps on the floor. I thought it was just trash, but they ended up being computer scraps. And what was weird is that Chirag would always have a bag with him, and he would put some scraps in the bag, and I would question his sanity, because who, as a child, would take computer scraps home with them? Well, he did. So I was very intrigued by this, because I never knew a kid that took computer scraps home with him, and let alone could do anything with it. So instead of asking him what he did, I decided I could find out by myself. So my curious seventh grade mind went to his house and climbed in through his window. And yes, I did climb through his window. I didn't have to break glass because there were no glasses on the window. So I climbed in, and what I expected to see was just like a pile of scraps in the corner of the room. But what I actually saw was a desktop computer. Now that really just shocked me, because I knew Chirag couldn't go and buy a computer, because I knew his family situation. They didn't have all the money. They didn't have all the resources. So when he got home later that day, I asked him, why? Why did you get this? How did you get this? And this is what he told me. So now you can see we have a drive here, and Chirag said that the reason that he wanted a computer was because he wanted to play a game. That game was called Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, and it is probably one of the most fun games that you've ever played in your life. He saw everybody playing that game, and he really, really wanted to play it. But again, his parents didn't have the money to go and buy him a computer. So he took it into his own hands. He knew that there was that store, and he knew that there were the scraps, and he somewhat had the idea of how a computer looked, so he said, why not just make it myself? So that's what he did. He ended up making that computer himself, and how many kids do you know have actually went out and made a computer themselves? Probably not a lot. But think about that, something so silly like that, wanting to play a game, how did that lead to this? Well, because he had that drive, he really wanted to play that game, so he used that drive to overcome his situation. And he finally had that computer. And this actually inspired me to create a type of process, which the process goes like this. You have a drive, and that drive, again, can be used to overcome a situation. And that leads to innovation. But now you may be asking, okay, I wasn't born in a third world country. I actually have some money. So what is my situation? Well, to make that even clearer, let me give you more of a personal example. So a few years ago, coming into ninth grade, I wanted to be a cool kid. Yeah, cool. So what happened was that I saw that people had these very cool shoes, and I really wanted those cool shoes because I was the kid that would come to school in Skechers, and my friends would roast me for 10 minutes straight, and it wouldn't feel good. So I went up to my dad and I said, "Dad, can I have these bad boys right here? These right here are the Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG City of Flight colorways. That's a lot of words. I'm just gonna call them Jordans." So I asked my dad, "Can I have these Jordans?" And he instantly said, "What's the price?" He really wanted to know what they cost. I told him reluctantly, $180. He looked at me with that strict parental look and said no. I was not getting those shoes anytime soon from him because he said that it was just a waste. Why would he buy me shoes, which he knew that I would probably mess up in a few days. And he was right, knowing me. So I really wanted to just stop there because I thought I couldn't get these shoes at this point, but I had my drive. I wanted to look cool. I didn't want to be roasted anymore. So I saw that one of my friends who had money and actually had a lot of these shoes, I saw that he wasn't the best at math. He kind of sucked at math. So I offered to tutor him. And I tutored him for a while. It was actually a few months. He would take away my Sundays from me and I wouldn't like it, but I knew that I was building up to something special because once he passed his final exam in math, I asked him, "Can you give me these shoes?" And he said, "Sure." And as you can see now, I have these shoes. So look. I know that's the silliest thing you've ever heard. How can that be a situation? Well, I mean, I just told you, that is a situation. My dad told me that he couldn't buy me these shoes, so I took it into my own hands. I had that drive. I took that drive and was able to overcome my situation to the point where I have these shoes now. So now, when you go home today, I want you to think, what is your drive? What is your situation? And most importantly, what are your Jordans?